हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ टॉपिक मेंडल्स लॉ ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस। दिस टॉपिक इज अंडर प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मेंडल्स लॉज ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस अंडर द चैप्टर प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन। प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस एंड वेरिएशन। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अब सर्टेन टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज अ टर्मिनोलॉजी यूज हु गिव द टर्म जेनेटिक्स व्हाट इज इनहेरिटेंस व्हाट इज वेरिएशंस एंड बिसाइड दिस वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट व्हाट इज डिफरेंट कैरेक्टर सेलेक्टेड बाई मेंडल। इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मेंडल्स लॉ ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस। विच टाइप ऑफ क्रॉस मेंडल परफॉर्म आर लिस्टेड इन द डिफरेंट लॉज। द मेंडल परफॉर्म बेसिकली टू टाइप ऑफ क्रॉसेस। फर्स्ट इज अ मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस एंड डाईहाइब्रिड। मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस एंड सेकेंड इज डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। मोनोहाइब्रिड एंड डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। फर्स्ट लेट अस टॉक अबाउट व्हाट इज मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। द मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस इन स्टेट्स दैट व्हेन सिंगल कैरेक्टर कंसीडर एट अ टाइम फॉर क्रॉसिंग। मींस इफ आउट ऑफ सेवन कैरेक्टर्स ओनली वन कैरेक्टर इज सेलेक्टेड फॉर क्रॉसिंग। सपोज द हाइट ऑफ प्लांट्स, द सीड शेप, इन द फ्लावर कलर, एनी ऑफ द कैरेक्टर इफ वी सेलेक्ट फॉर क्रॉसिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ क्रॉस इज कंसिडर अंडर द मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। द टू प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ मेंडल्स लॉ फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल इज लॉ ऑफ डोमिनेंस एंड सेकेंड प्रिंसिपल इज लॉ ऑफ प्योरिटी ऑफ गैमिट इज बेस्ड ऑन मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। व्हाइल द लॉ ऑफ डोमिनेंस बेस्ड ऑन डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। स्टूडेंट्स, इन मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस सिंगल कैरेक्टर कंसीडर अ टाइम। लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड बाय टेकिंग एग्जांपल्स। सपोज अ टॉल प्लांट हैविंग जीनोटाइप कैपिटल टीटी क्रॉस विथ ड्वार्फ प्लांट हैविंग जीनोटाइप स्मॉल टीटी। मीन्स दिस इज कंसीडर टॉल एंड ड्वार्फ इज कंसीडर अंडर हाइट ऑफ प्लांट। दिस बोथ कैरेक्टर इज कंसिडर अंडर द हाइट ऑफ द प्लांट। दिस इज अ सिंगल कैरेक्टर। इफ यू आर कंपेयरिंग द हाइट ऑफ द प्लांट, दिस इज अंडर द सिंगल कैरेक्टर। सो दिस इज कंसिडर अंडर द मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस। द रिजल्ट ऑब्टेन वी कैन सी द हाइब्रिड प्लांट the height of plants, especially the tall plant cross with dwarf plant, tall plant having genotype capital TT and dwarf plant having genotype small t, they form gamete capital T and small t. In F1 generation they form capital T and small t. Means due to law of dominance, after this topic मोनोहाइब्रिड एंड डाईहाइब्रिड आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट लॉ ऑफ डोमिनेंस। देन आई विल टॉल्ड अबाउट हाउ द कैपिटल टी मास्क या डोमिनेंट जीन मास्क द कैरेक्टर ऑफ रिसेसिव जीन। दिस विल बी टॉल ड्यू टू लॉ ऑफ डोमिनेंस। दो यू कैन से द सिंगल कैरेक्टर टॉल प्लांट क्रॉस विद ड्वार्फ प्लांट्स दे फॉर्म in F1 generation, especially tall plant upon selfing they produce gene of two type suppose this is a male plant, this is a female plants, they produce gene capital T and small t. Upon selfing, this is a self cross, and upon selfing they produce capital T T gene, they produce capital T small t. Capital T small t, and then fourth is a small t small t. This can be, this is a result of F2 generation. This is a pure homozygous dominant gene, this is a heterozygous gene, this is a heterozygous, and this is a homozygous dwarf gene. What is homozygous and heterozygous? Homozygous conditions are those if any, for any character, the individual having both gene are similar, that is both either dominant or recessive. If the capital TT, this will be the homozygous, small TT homozygous, capital RR homozygous, small RR homozygous. This is a different form of allele, means you can say this is a capital TT allele, small TT allele, capital RR small RR allele. This one is a homozygous condition. And in heterozygous condition, heterozygous condition, capital T and small t means one dominant gene, one recessive gene. This is under heterozygous. Capital R and small r, capital Y and small y, this one is under heterozygous condition. Students, let us talk about how you can perform experiment. I think most of the students not able to understand how this is happen, means how crosses is performed between two different characters containing plants. Suppose this a single plant is pea plants we have taken, and seed taken from that and grown in the field. They produce many plants in the fields. One is a dominant characters having tall, and another is a recessive character having dwarf in shape, dwarf size plants. Both produce flower. At the time, because a pea plant is a self-pollinating plants, performing desired pollination, we perform emasculation. Means if the tall plant want to cross with dwarf plant, then the dwarf plant anther is removed at juvenile stage. Means the dwarf plant flower is unisexual. Then the pollen grain from the tall plant is taken and dusted on a stigma of dwarf plant. Then it is of fertilization. This indicate this. After then, suppose the tall plant having capital T gene in their pollen grain gamete, and dwarf plant having the small T gene containing egg, and they fertilize there. Fertilize to form a zygote, zygote develop to form embryo, embryo present inside the seed. When the dwarf plant containing seed grown in the field, then it form another plant. This will be the nature of this type. And due to presence of a capital gene or dominant gene, it mask suppress the character of recessive gene. Especially here I am talking about gene, then gene having two type of allele is a capital, and you can say two type of allele, and that two type of allele may be both homozygous nature. One will be tall, one will be dwarf, and both will be dwarf. This nature will happen in all many cases. Okay, suppose this plant is grown, this will be the F1 progeny offspring. After that, the not a single plant grown in F1 generation, many plants are grown, suppose all are tall. Then two plant again selected and perform cross between both, and they form, suppose one of them make male plant and one of them make female plants. Male plants having this type of genotype, and female plant also having same, because both are produced from a same progeny, sorry, same generations. So one is a male, one is will be female. You can make which one be male and which one be a female. This one is a male plant form two type of gamete again by meiosis, is a capital T and a small t having both in both gametes, same in this case also. And upon fertilization, this is a ray diagram, is it can be also understand by the Punnett square, Punnett square. Suppose this is a area of male gamete represented here. Male gamete produce capital T, this one is a small t, and a female plant produce gametes here, capital T and small t. Then capital T in one box, capital T, small t in another, then capital T and small t in this box, and small t in this. This one is a form a tall, this one is a form a tall due to presence of one dominant gene, this one is a form tall also due to presence of one dominant gene, and this is a form a dwarf due to presence of both dwarf gene. The ratio of monohybrid cross is always phenotype and genotype ratio of the monohybrid cross, phenotype ratio, tall is to dwarf, the ratio is 3 tall phenotypes and 1 dwarf phenotype. This is a phenotype ratio. Now the genotype ratio is 3 type of gene present, capital TT is to capital T, small t and small t, small t. The ratio will be 1:2:1, because one is a capital TT gene, one another is a capital T small t, this is in 2 in number, and small t is a 1 in number. This is a ratio of monohybrid cross. This is a ratio of monohybrid cross in pea plants. Now the another laws, sorry, the laws based on monohybrid cross. The law based on monohybrid cross is of two types. First is law of dominance. Law of dominance states that law of dominance based on monohybrid cross, it states that when the gene that control characters having two form, one is a two form of allele, one is a dominant allele and another is a recessive allele, then dominant allele will suppress the character of recessive allele. Means this is known as law of dominance. The same cross, suppose same cross that are presented earlier is explained in the law of dominance. You can revise it back and understand same crossing process in the law of dominance. This is a law of dominance. Some exception, some plants not follow the law of dominance, because if one dominant gene, one recessive gene are present, and the result should be the due to the character formed by dominant allele, it is not happen. Some intermediate character is also formed in them. This is known as incomplete dominance. Some exception of this law. Some exception of this law is incomplete dominance, and also incomplete dominance, and second is codominance. Second is dominance. So this one is an exception. This we'll discuss in later classes. Later part of these chapters. Now the second law of the monohybrid cross is law of purity of gamete. Second law is law of purity of gamete. Law of purity of gamete is also called law of segregation. Law of segregation. This law states that when the two allele present in the genotype present in the plants for long duration, they are never blend, never mix. If they get time, they are segregate easily, they separate easily, joined with another combination and form another characters. Let us stand this top this law by crosses. Suppose if you perform a cross between height of the plants, such as the tall plants cross with dwarf plants having genotype capital TT. This is a dwarf plant having genotype small tt. They produce, this one is a phenotype, this is a plant genotype, this is a form gamete capital T and small t. Especially they form homozygous gamete. They are not form single gamete. They can form, because two genes are present, they form many gametes, especially of same genotype. Especially suppose a plant having capital T, T, they form two gametes, capital T, T. But I'm not, because both are same gamete, so singly we represent here. This one is a gamete. They form cross between both after pollination, fertilization, so on. In F1 generation, they form means capital T and small t combined together. And they, due to dominance, they form tall character. Here you can see both different genotypes present in it. Suppose after fertilization, the both tall and dwarf gene present in the embryo seed. They grow in the field up to the growing all plant bodies. All this genetic combination present in the body for long duration. But one interesting thing that they present in the body for long duration, but they are never blend. They are again segregated both separately. Both segregated each other, separated each other, and combined with other combinations to form new genotype or phenotype. In F2 generation, they form gamete. Capital C, the plants form gamete capital T and small t upon selfing, capital T small t. If we perform self cross, capital T and small t, they form gamete capital T and small t. Means allele of capital T and allele of small t, allele of capital T and allele of small t. What is allele? You know that a gene, suppose both allele present together to form a gene combinations and they show characters. Allele doesn't individually form characters. Allele is haploid form of gene. You can say haploid form of gene means if gene present in diploid forms, then it having two forms, capital T and small t, capital T, T, small t, T. This one type of different combination of allele, and it is also known as allelomorph. Now the capital T and suppose in F2 generation, after Punnett square, I think this is not so in videos. Now Punnett square, this is a, suppose this is a male plant, this is a symbol of male, this is a symbol of female, and this is a male plants. They form gamete, capital T, small t. This one is a capital T, small t. Not capital. This one is a gamete, capital T, small t in case of male, and capital T, small t in case of female. Capital TT produce tall characters, and tall character, capital T and small t produce dwarf character. Small t, capital T and small t produce tall character, and this is a small t produce dwarf character. The ratio is same as like monohybrid cross in lot dominance. Phenotype will be the ratio of phenotype is the 3:1, and genotype ratio will be here 1:2:1. Students, the topic is lot purity of gamete. How we can say the gamete is pure? You know that in F1 generation, the this type of genotype present in the plant body for long duration. Means the whole plant growing, then form flower, then produce gametes. Means this total duration, about suppose this is a pea plant, so this having gene in up to 6 to 7 months in the plants. But in suppose if the higher plant or higher plant present in higher plants, the gene present for long duration, many years. But at the time of gamete formation, both are separated. Both are separated. And both are segregated, separate to each other. And they are independent, means suppose they having a tall capital T, and which type of pollen grain come to this plant and combine with them, it is not decide, means it is random. Any type of plants combinations of same characters combine it to form a genotype. Suppose here male gamete at capital T is reach to them, and another is a capital T reach to this small t. They form, one is a homozygous condition again. They start from homozygous condition. In F2 generation again they retain homozygous condition. They start at dwarf conditions, again they retain small TT conditions in F2 generation. Means again they are pure homozygous condition retain. This overall result indicate that the gamete are pure, they are independent, not independent, gamete are pure. If they combine with other, they form, combine with other, they form new geno and phenotype. Means gamete are pure, always pure, never blend with each other, never influenced by any other combinations if they are present in the plant body for long duration. So you can say this is law of purity of gamete. The no one exception till date is reported of this law. Beside this law of dominance having exceptions, I already told you. The next law that are based on the dihybrid cross having some exceptions in form of epistasis and interaction gene base. Now the next law is law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment is same as like law of purity of gamete, but it is slight advance. Law of independent assortment is based on the dihybrid cross. Dihybrid cross means two character consider at a time. Mendel want to see if in single character they are not blend. What happen in two characters? The main objective behind this was, is character or blend, two different character or blend or not. This was the main objective. So they performed dihybrid crosses. Dihybrid cross of Mendel was Mendel's third law, Mendel's law of independent independent assortment. This law states that the gametes are independent. They assorted easily, means separated easily. This law based on two type of characters. This law based on dihybrid cross. And you know that in dihybrid cross, two character consider at a time. First character was that selected by Mendel was seed shape, and second character was seed color. Seed shape of seed shape, the dominant character is seed shape, dominant character is round, and recessive character is wrinkled. Seed color is dominant character yellow, and recessive character is green. Suppose this is a dominant character that taken, and this is a recessive character that we are going to take for cross. The phenotype apparent is, suppose round yellow seeded plant cross with wrinkled green seeded plants. Round yellow represented by capital RR capital YY, wrinkled green represented by small RR and small YY. This is a genotype. They produce gamete. Capital R capital Y and small r small y. The question asked regarding this: a plant having genotype combination is capital RR. Question. This one is a question. Capital RR capital Y. Capital YY. This is a genotype combination. Question is, how many type of gamete produced by this combination? Answer is single type. How many in number? 4. You can see this is a capital RR capital YY. They form combination with capital R, form combination with capital Y. Capital R form combination with another capital Y. This capital R form combination with capital R capital Y. This form a combination of capital R capital Y. Means these are 4 gamete. All are same type. This question asked in many, you can see your examinations. This is a slight loose question. I think most students know this, but this is important to understand this. Now another question related to this: if the combination is capital R small r, capital Y small y, how many type of gamete and how many in number they form gamete? Answer is they form 4 type of gamete in 4 number. Matlab means they form 4 type of gamete in 4 in number. You can say this capital R form combination first with form both are homozygous dominant gene. This form combination with the capital R small y, this is a another type of combination. One is a dominant, one is a recessive gene. This form capital R is for small r capital Y combination. You can see this is a small r and small y combination. You can see this is a very interesting. Similar result questions is also asked in how many gametes and how many gametes form and how many types of gametes are formed from this combination. If many question is asked small r capital Y small y, which type of gametes and how many number gametes formed by this type of combinations, this is a very interesting questions. You can solve if you are practicing well, understand well. Now students, the gamete formed by this type of combination is capital R, capital Y, small y. In F1 generation, the combination is capital R, combination is capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. This is due to presence of one dominant gene. Due to presence of one dominant gene, they mask the character of other recessive gene. Means the this is due to presence of one dominant gene, the character will be the round for this, and due to presence of capital Y, suppress the character of small y. This will be the round yellow seeded plant in F1 generation. Means the F1 generation producing plants having all type of plant will be the dominant, showing dominant characters. But upon selfing, if perform self cross, means same type of genetic combination, capital R small r, capital Y small y, of same generation plants, what result will observe in F2 generation? Now you can see this is a capital R small r, capital Y small y form four type of gamete. First is a capital R, capital Y, capital R small y, small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. These four type of genes, same type of genes is also formed upon by same plants. This is a self pollinating plant. Now this is a four type of gene, and this is also produce four type of gametes, four type of gametes this also produce. Now 4 multiply by 4 in F2 generation, total 16 plant produce. Now we form 16 punnet column by punnet square, and in one side this is a punnet square, column we form here. This one is represents the site of male plant gamete, capital R, capital Y. Another is capital R, capital small r, capital Y, small y. How they form gamete? Capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y. Another is small r, capital Y, and small r, small y. These four type of in both plants. Suppose this is a male plant, this is a female plant upon selfing. First is a gene gametes that bear genotype capital Y, capital R small y. Another is a small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Another is same in case of female plants also here. Capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, and small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Students, I am going to perform cross between all. We can also produce by this type of crosses, but they are more complex and unable to understand, unable to distinguish. Punnett square is very important, and it may easy to understand how the crosses we are perform. This is a capital R, capital Y, and this is a capital R, capital R. Capital R, R combination is formed in this capital YY. This is a capital R, and this is a capital R, this is a capital Y, this is a small y, this is a capital R, this is a small r, this is a capital Y, this is a capital Y, this is a capital R, this is a small r, this is a capital Y, this is a small y. In first row even. Now, in second, capital R, capital Y, small y. Here, capital R, small y, in both cases. R, small y, capital Y. Capital always written first. Small y. Now, student, in this combination, is capital R, small r, capital Y. Here, small r, capital Y. Students, small r, capital Y. Now, third, fourth is gamete. Here, capital R, small r, capital Y. In next, capital R, small y. Next, small r, capital Y. In fourth, small r, small y. This one is a different genotype in all 16 combination. Here both are dominant. Here capital R, capital Y. Capital R represent round yellow. Capital R also represent round. And due to presence of one capital Y, this is also shows dominant character yellow. This is presence of capital R round. Here capital Y represent yellow character. Here the capital R, capital Y both shows their dominance. This is a round character, will be round and yellow. In this row, the capital R shows round and capital Y shows yellow character. Here this shows capital R round, but small yy so special. Small yy shows green, round green. In this case also, capital R, due to presence of dominant gene, this is also shows round green. Here also one combination is same as like this. Round green. Here, due to presence of one dominant gene, this will be the round yellow. Here, due to presence of both dominant gene, the character will be the round yellow. Here, one dominant gene, both, this will be the, in both cases one dominant gene present that correct suppress the character of recessive gene. This will be the round yellow. This will be the, next is a small rr, is capital yy, small rr. This one is a special. Small r represent wrinkled character, wrinkled, and capital yy represent yellow, wrinkled yellow, very special new character. This is a, here also this is small rr shows wrinkled and capital Y shows yellow. This also shows small wrinkled yellow. Here again this is a small wrinkled green, and this is a, this will be the round yellow. Students, this is a law of independent assortment based on dihybrid cross. Name indicate law of independent assortment means gamete are independent. They combine with other genotypic combination and form new characters also. They are able to form new character. Students, here we are taking a combination with round yellow and wrinkled green. You know that the round yellow number is 9. If we observe the ratio phenotype, 4 type phenotype combination is formed. First is round yellow, second combination seen round green, third combination seen wrinkled yellow, and fourth combination seen wrinkled green. The round yellow plant observed in ratio in 9. Round green ratio observed in number 3. Wrinkled yellow ratio observed in number 3, and wrinkled green observed in ratio 1. Student, we are taken here plants round yellow, wrinkled green. The plant should form in all generation round yellow, wrinkled green plants. But this two new combination, round green and wrinkled yellow, this is a two new combination in 3-3 number, shows a new combination, a new character in F2 generation. This indicates that the gametes are independent. They cannot be associated with same type of allele for many generation. They may be separated, segregated, and each generation and form new combinations. This was the base of monohybrid. Means gamete are independent here. This is a phenotype ratio is a 9:3:3:1. The genotype ratio is also asked. Genotype, if we write this all type of ratio, this is a single, this one is a same type, this one is a also same type, this is also here same type. If we consider all, we can find the ratio of genotype ratio is 1:2, 2:2, 2:4:2, 1:2, 2:2, 1:2, 2:1. You can write, learn it very well. 12:24, 12:12:1. It is possible to learn 12:24, 12:12:1. If you write all genotype ratio, this is the law of independent assortment. So what is the basic difference you have learned in this class? What is a monohybrid cross? What is dihybrid cross? What is a law of dominance? What is a law of purity of gamete, law of segregation? And third is a law of independent assortment. Some book is not basically focus on law of dominance because this was many exceptions. Only they focus on law purity of gamete and law of independent assortment. Some question is asked about what is test cross. In many book, what is test cross? How test cross perform? Test cross perform to check what genotype ratio present inside the, what is the genotype present inside the F1 generation. Let us talk about test cross. Test cross perform the cross of F1 generation plant with their recessive parent. This can be understood by taking an example of monohybrid cross. Suppose if we talk about loft dominance, if you talk about loft dominance, we are focused basically on test cross. What? Test cross. Loft dominance shows that this is a tall and this is a dwarf plant having genotype capital TT, small tt. In F1 generation, they produce capital T, small t. And in F1 generation, they produce capital T, small t. We understand this. We only observe a plant from morphologically, not going detail about genotype. Not it is a very difficult to identify the genotype conditions of the cell. Then if the plant is tall dwarf cross having F1 generation will be, this is not known. This situation, suppose this is a tall plant, the situation will be here, the capital TT and capital T small TT. But this is not exact, it doesn't know. Then for knowing the exact position of genotype, we perform test cross, capital T and small t, not test cross means both recessive, in test cross F1 generation individual cross with their recessive parents a dwarf character. If any other character also, then I may be also recessive parents also. Here small t will be genotype. Here single gametes are formed. Not single, two gametes you can form also. Here two gametes, capital T, small t. Students, this one is a capital T, small t. I think this is a not well. Students, you can understand this by Punnett square. Suppose this is a male plants. Produce two type of gamete, capital T, small t, and this is a dwarf recessive parent, produce gamete, small t, capital T, female plant, this is a capital T, small t, form tall characters, small t, then form dwarf character, and capital T, small t, tall characters, and small t, dwarf character. Students, here the ratio of, you can say tall, dwarf, ratio of, you can say 50-50 means 1:1, means equal ratio observed. In F2 generation by test cross, if focus on this, students, if the F1 individual is heterozygous upon selfing in F2 generation, they produce ratio of 50-50% individuals. You can say 1:1 ratio in F2 generation upon self. But if the F1 progeny, what will be the parents? I don't know. If the F1 progeny is homozygous tall condition, then in F1 generation all individual will be tall, because this will be the dominant gene and this form all dominant characters all are tall in this. But if the F1 individual is recessive, heterozygous conditions, recessive, it is not need to cross because it is already recessive, you can identify it. Test cross perform basically to know the homozygosity and heterozygosity conditions of the F1 generation individual, means they are homozygous or heterozygous. If the both plants, if the F1 generation individual plants have both same genotypes, that is dominant, means because plant are tall, or they are in heterozygous conditions. In this chapter, students, I think these chapters will help you in many ways to learn about the Mendelian concept, especially the law of Mendel's, laws given by Mendel's. In next class, in next part of this class, I will understand about next portion of what is a mutation, what is a linkage, and what is different disorders of the Mendelian concept, especially hemophilia, Klinefelter syndromes, and many others. Thank you.